Good morning dear students. In this video you are going to learn about lesson number 4, linear equations in two variables. Now what we have to learn here, that first of all you have to revise what is linear equation or what are linear equations. So I am writing it. In a flowchart way, that linear equation, you have studied about linear equations in one variable. And now you are going to learn about linear equations in two variables. Now in linear equation in one variable and two variables, what you are going to see, that is solutions of linear equations. Solutions of linear equations in one variable and solutions of linear equation in two variables. Now, along with this, in linear equation in two variables, you are going to learn that what is the general form of linear equation in two variables. In this you are going to learn about drawing graph. Graph of linear equation in two variables. In this graph, you are going to learn that equations in two variables, draw a graph of equation in two variables and secondly, equations of lines parallel to axis. It means lines parallel to y axis and lines parallel to x-axis. So let's start with the introduction of linear equations, that is linear equation in one variable and linear equation in two variables. You have studied that what is linear equation in one variable. Let's take an example. Example here, that 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. So how do we get the root of this? So root of linear equation is x is equal to minus 3 upon 2. Now how to represent this linear equation in one variable on number line? So we represent this roots of linear equation in one variable as by drawing this equal units, right of 0, positive, left of 0, negative. And then our root of this is represented on number line. like year, that is minus 3 upon 2. So this is nothing but root of equation 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. So now how to represent linear equation in two variables we are going to learn, but before that we will see what is linear equation in two variables. So here linear equations in two variables. So let's take an example that Rina and Nina make 86 garlands together. So how to represent this information in equation form? So what we write? Let garlands made by Rina be x and Nina be y. And then we have taken two different variables for number of garlands made by Rina and Nina, and then we get the equation as x plus y is equal to 86. So this is nothing but a linear equation in two variables where we use two different variables and we make a linear equation. Thus, while solving the linear equations or any kind of equations, you have to keep in mind few things, that is here I'm giving you. First of all, by solving the linear equation, by solving the equations, few points you have to keep in mind. That is, first thing is you can add the solution of equation does not affect when first thing when same number added or subtracted from both sides of equation. So addition and subtraction of same number will not affect the solution of given equation. And secondly, same non-zero number multiplied or divided on both sides of equation. So here, for example, if I add in this equation plus 4 and if I to RHS and plus 4 to RHS, LHS and RHS, the equation remains same. Or if you subtract 4 and 4, even the equation or solution of this equation won't affect, it won't change. Similarly, in linear equation in two variables, same addition, subtraction and multiplication and division of non-zero number, same non-zero number, won't affect solution of given equation. So thus we have seen one example of linear equation in two variables, that is x plus y is equal to 86. So here we can write 2a plus 4b is equal to 31. We can write even 5s plus 3t is equal to 5. So this is how we can write many examples of linear equations where two variables are given. And thus what we can say, that any equation in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, where a and b are not 0, is called a linear equation in two variables. So here the coefficient of variables should not be 0. A and B should not be 0. Then we can express the equation in this form as linear equation in two variables. So let's see the examples from exercise 4.1. This is the first question of exercise 4.1. The cost of a notebook is twice the cost of a pen. Write a linear equation in two variables to represent a statement. So we start with the statement like, let the cost of notebook be x. Now we have to represent in two variables, the equation in two variables. That's why the cost of pen B, pen is equal to y. Now what they have given, the condition is that cost of notebook is twice, means two times, cost of pen. And that's why according to question, equation will be x is equal to 2y. So this is the equation in two variables. We can write it in a general form like x minus 2y is equal to 0. This is the general form of equation comparing with ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Let's solve a second example. Express the following equations in the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 and indicate values of a, b and c. Now x minus y upon 5 minus 10 is equal to 0. This is the question number 2, sub main question 2, exercise 4.1. So here what 5 is a denominator, we don't want, we have to remove it from here. So how we will remove it? Dividing the equation by so what we get here, it's not dividing, sorry, it's multiplying, because it is division. So multiplying equations equation by 5. So here we get each and every term multiplied by 5. So here we get 5x or 5x minus y upon 5 into 5 minus 10 into 5 is equal to 0 into 5. So when we are dividing, multiplying or dividing, each and every term gets multiplied or divided as per what is instruction given. So what we have here, this gets cancelled and the equation we get is 5x minus y minus 50 is equal to 0. Now if you compare this equation with the general form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, this is the equation in this form. And now they have asked us to indicate the values of a, b and c. So here a is coefficient of x. Now, so that is a is 5. Now b, y doesn't have coefficient, but we know that when nothing is there we put 1. So what is the coefficient of 5? That is minus 1, along with sign which is written left of number to be taken. And what is c? So c is again along with sign we have to take. C is minus 50. Let's solve the next example. Question is 2x is equal to minus 5y. It is from exercise 4.1, question number 2, sub-question 5. So we have to write this in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So we are transposing this minus 5y to LHS. So we get here 2x, when transposing minus becomes plus, and we write this in this form. So this is equal to ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Now here what we have, a adds 2, coefficient of x. What we have, coefficient of y, 5. And b is 5. And c is, we do not have c term over here, constant term we do not have. So we can write c as 0. So again, by expressing linear equation in two variables, what we should have, the condition is a and b, a and b, they should not be equal to 0. C could be equal to 0, but they should not be equal to 0. So with this, you can solve the remaining sums of exercise 4.1. And let's move to the next concept, solution of a linear equation. As you know, you have studied or you have seen that linear equation in one variable has a unique solution. It has one and only one unique solution. Now we will see the linear equations, how we get the solutions of linear equation. So we will learn about solution of linear equation in two variables. Now previously I have given you the example like x plus y is equal to 86. So we have seen this example for forming the equation in two variables. So here just look at this 86. So 86 number can be paired like 80 plus 6. It could be 81 plus 5. It could be 79 plus 7. It could be minus 8 plus, if you take this as an integer, negative integer, then it could be minus 8 and plus 94. So it means this 86 can be expressed in sum of many numbers or pair of numbers, and that's why what we say, that linear equation in two variables has infinitely many solutions. So what is our observation from this example? That thus we can say that linear equation in two variables has infinitely many solutions. So let's see this with one more example. For example, if we have equation like 2x plus 3y is equal to 5. Then what will be the value of x and 5? Adding these, 2x plus 3y gives us 5. So here we can take, suppose we take here as taking x is equal to 0, what we get here, this whole term is 0 plus 3y is equal to 5, that gives us y is equal to 5 upon 3. So what will be the solution of this equation when x is 0, y we get 5 upon 3. So the solution here is 0, 5 upon 3. Second case, if we take y is equal to 0, then it gives us whole this term is 0, and then we get 2x is equal to plus 0 is equal to 5. So x we get as 5 upon 2. So what the solutions we get here? That 5 upon 2 comma 0. So here the one thing we have to be careful, that is the x value we write in the bracket first, comma, and then y value. Third, if we taking x is equal to 1, then it is 2 into 1 gives us 2 plus 3y is equal to 5. Solving this, transposing this 2 to this side, we get 3y is equal to 5 minus 2, so 3y is equal to 3, and then finally y we get as 1. So the solution, one more solution we get for this equation as x is 1 and y also we get 1. So this is how we can find many solutions for this given equation. Let's solve one more example to find the solutions of linear equation in two variables. The equation given is 4x plus 3y is equal to 12. So here if we take x as 0, then you know that this whole term becomes 0, 4 into 0, 0. So here we get as 3y is equal to 12. So finally we get here y as 12. Transposing this or dividing this to other side, we get here y as 4. So here we write the solutions in the form like 0, 4. Next, if we take x as minus 1, first we take x as 1, so 1. So here 4 ones are 4. Plus 3y is equal to 12. Means we have to put the value of x in the given equation. So here by putting 1 in place of x, we get this whole term as 4 ones are 4 plus 3y is equal to 12. So here we get 3y is equal to 12. transposing this plus 4 to this side, you get minus 4. So here we have 3y is equal to 8, and that's why y is equal to 8 upon 3. So the solutions here, 1 comma 8 upon 3. Y value we write always second. If we have, sorry, it is, we have taken here, no, it's correct. So here, if we have x is equal to minus 1, we can take any value, any integer, positive integer, negative integer. So what we get here, that 4 into minus 1 gives us minus 4 plus 3y is equal to 12. So here we get this as, by transposing this minus 4, it becomes plus 4. So it is plus 4, 12 plus 4. And that's why we get 3y is equal to 16, y is equal to 16 upon 3. So the solution for, with x as minus 1, we get y as 16 upon 3. So this is how we can get infinitely many solutions for this equation, 4x plus 3y is equal to 12. And now this we write in a tabular form, like we can write this in tabular form like x and y. So x is when 0, y is 4. When x is 1, y is 8 upon 3. When x is minus 1, y is 16 upon 3. So this is how we can represent the solutions or solution of linear equation in two variables in this form as well. Let's move to the next example. This is the question number 1 of exercise 4.2. Which one of the following option is true and why? Y is equal to 3x plus 5 has unique solution, only two solutions, or infinitely many solutions. So as the first two examples we saw, what will be the answer here? That this equation is equation in two variables. So for every value of x, there will be a corresponding value of y. So here what will be our answer? That is infinitely many solutions, because it is, we can write, it is a linear equation in two variables. And that's why for every value of x, there will be a corresponding value of y. The fourth question is, write four solutions for the following equation. Pi x plus y is equal to 9. This is a sub-question 2 of question number 2, exercise 4.2. So here again, we will take as x is equal to 0. What we get here? When x is 0, hold this term will be 0. And that's why 0 plus y is equal to 9. That gives us y value as 9. So what will be the solution here? When we have x is 0, y is 9. Secondly, if we take x is 1, then if x is 1, we get pi into 1 is pi plus y is equal to 9. So here we get y is equal to 9. Transposing this pi to RHS, we get minus pi. And that's why our solution here is x is 1, then y will be 9 minus pi. Third, if we take y at 0, then what? So if we have y at 0, we have here pi x plus 0 is equal to 9. That gives us pi x is equal to 9, which means x is equal to 9 upon pi. So here solution could be x is 9 upon pi and y is 0. They have asked us to find 4 solutions. So one more solution we will take as if x is equal to, suppose we take minus 1. So what now? If we have minus 1 in place of x, minus 1 into pi gives us minus pi plus y is equal to 9. So finally we get here y as 9. Transposing this minus pi to RHS we get plus pi. And then the solution for this equation will be, one more solution for this equation, that is minus 1, 9 plus pi. And we can write this in these solutions in tabular form like x, y. When x is 0, y is 9. When x is 1, y is 9 minus 5. When x is 9 upon 11, y is 0. And when x is minus 1, y is 9 plus 5. So it's not 11, it's 5. 9 upon 5. So here our answer is 9 upon 5. Then y is 0. Moving to the fifth example, check whether of the following are solutions of equation x minus 2y is equal to 4 and which not. First question is the solutions given 4 comma 0, and in second question it is 2 root square root 2 comma 4 square root 2. These are the questions of exercise 4.2, question number 3, second and fourth sub questions. So first they have given us, given equation is x minus 2y is equal to 4. Now if we take solutions as, in the first case, if we take solution as 4, 0, it means x is 4 and y is 0. So by putting the values of x and y in this equation, what we get? 4 minus 2 into 0 is equal to 4. Whether it is, so we can take this as LHS here. We have to check it, so we will take as LHS. LHS is what? X minus 2. So we put the values, x is 4, y is 0. So finally we get this as 4 minus 0, it means 4, which is equal to RHS. So what we say hence, 4 comma 0 is solution. Now we will see second case where we have the solutions. We have to check whether the given values are solutions of the equation or not. So what we will take? LHS. So LHS is, first we write the LHS in xy form, x minus 2y, put the value of x is root 2 minus 2 into 4 root 2. So here we get value as root 2 minus 8 root 2, which is not equal to 4, which is RHS. It means here LHS is not equal to RHS. And that's why hence we say what? That root 2, 4 root 2 is not solution. Let's see the last example of this type. Find the value of k if x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1 is solution of equation 2x plus 3y is equal to k. So this equation is given and these are the solutions of equation. So what by putting x and y's value in this equation we get here by putting x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1 we get 2 into 1 plus 3 2 into 2 by x value is 2 into plus 3 into y 1 is equal to k. So here 4 plus 3 is equal to k. So finally k is equal to 7. So this is how we get the value of k. So this kind of sums are mostly asked in exam and they are for 1 mark. So you have to solve, you have to give this much presentation for the sum. So this is how we will see the next concept in the next video. Till then, solve the sums from exercise 4.1 and 4.2.